offices will also be closed. If you need a shelter, the one Juno Beach needs to head to is Palm Beach Gardens Community High School. Also,
we continue to evacuate across all of South Florida right now in Delray Beach. Those police officers blocking off the entrances to the barrier island. And that's where we find John Genovese with more.
Hey everybody, sort of back. I've had my surgery. I know you can't really tell. I don't have any big things on my nose or anything. It didn't turn out as I expected. Much better, actually. They did the surgery. When I'm not congested right now, I can feel the difference when I breathe. But right now, I'm still in a fair amount of pain. I feel it in my sinuses up here and here, all the way over into my ears. I mean, it's definitely, it definitely had some work done. Hey, everybody. How are we doing this evening? Well, this is actually quite late at night. We're talking probably it's after 11, it's between 11 and midnight. Yeah, I'm a little bit still dealing with the medications from some of the painkillers, guys. Sorry, so I'm a little bit loopy in some ways, so I might have a little trouble keeping the camera pointed the right way on occasion, or I might lose train of thought momentarily or something, but I had to start doing this again. I have to get the creative juices going. Okay, so I got lots of nice, neat stuff this month when I went to the grocery store. And my goal was to do a vlog where we saw firsthand what I got at the grocery store, of course. Do some price comparison, show you how, we'll give you a demonstration on how I shop, because my method of shopping is basically, when I go into the store, I don't look at things as if I'm trying to make a meal. Okay? Understand, a meal consists of three items, always. Unless you're vegetarian or completely carnivorous. A meal consists of three primary portions. And those portions are protein, fiber, or in this case, veg, and starch. So when we prepare a meal, we think about what goes well with what. Well, sure, we can go by recipes and we can stockpile all these ingredients until we have no more room left in our cupboards, and it kind of looks like this, where it's a little out of, everything's out of place. You have a little bit of everything, or a lot of things that you really don't need. Now I've thinned mine out. Everything in there at this moment I use in one way or another. Used to be that bad with me. I used to have cupboards and cupboards and cupboards full. Now I'm down to just the area above my stove, and I'm actually getting ready to trim that down a bit. Thinking about building a nice little spice rack. Guys, you'll see me doing this. You'll see me doing this. I just had sinus surgery done. You can't see what they did, but basically they drilled holes going up into this portion of my sinuses for drainage, and then they drilled out some holes in this area of my sinuses for drainage, and then they also fixed the deviated septum. Now, deviated septum, if anybody has ever had a broken nose, you will know what I'm talking about when I say deviated septum. And normally, they put these big apparatuses in your nose. They're silicone, and they're big and puffy, and they're huge. And they put them in there, and that holds the septum in place, basically. Well, this time, they didn't do that. Not sure exactly why. I was actually curious as to when I woke up from the surgery. I honestly didn't think they did. I thought something went wrong and they weren't able to do it. I thought, and then I realized I had this little drip pad underneath my nose to catch any blood or mucus coming out of my nose. But amazingly, I felt wonderful. My breathing was completely cleared. And still is for the most part. Now, mind you, this is 3 days after the surgery. I'm behind on everything. I'm still putting together my budget shopping vlog. I'm starting... this is gonna be kind of crazy. Yeah, and then of course me being doped up on the painkillers, I have to do it after my kids go to bed because I can't take care of my children if I'm in an altered state of mind. So I wait for them to go to sleep so that I can take my painkillers. If there's an emergency, I know how to call for help. I know who to call for help. So right now you just have to deal with a little loopiness this late in the evening. A lot of what we're going to be doing will not be taking place this late in the evening, and I will not be this loopy. just for tonight, guys, hopefully. So it doesn't, I don't have priority, so it doesn't put me at the top of the list, so it takes a little bit longer. I'll spit out. I knew I could spit it out there. I'm hoping that you guys can see my screen with this camera over here. And I've got my other camera, my vlogging camera, on me here so you guys can see me and I can look at you easier. I might change how I do this. It's just going to depend. I really want you guys to be able to see this. In fact, I know exactly how I'm going to do this. We're going to stop that camera. Assuming that did it. And it did not. We can edit a bit, but that's life. Yeah, we're going to turn this iPhone off. Guys, my cameras, I can't afford a lot of technology, so this is one of my vlogging cameras. Oh, yay. Respawn at the temple. Okay, so what I'm gonna do here is I actually have a way to play my game and still let you, my fans, what few fans I do have, and thank you very much. I do appreciate you being there. Alrighty. Let's do this. Close this. Launch that. Now, this program that I'm using will actually, when it's turned on, will actually launch itself as soon as, and start recording as soon as I launch the game. So I can quite literally record my entire game
How awesome is that? And it does it with every game that I have. Some games it works better with. It's designed to work with certain games more so than others, etc., etc. So you kind of get the idea. But it's really neat. It's called Plays.tv. You get it with Raptor. Give me a moment here. Let's put you guys over here. I'm trying to find a little bit more comfortable position for me now that I took the other camera out of the way. And we're doing it this way, which works better for me. I've just got to get everything positioned just right. I've got to be picky, snobbish. I'll give you guys a little peek at some of the games that I play here over time. This is just my vlog, guys. I can't really do a lot of cooking without being able to taste, but I've got other things in the works. I'm putting together this awesome vlog, hopefully an awesome vlog about how to shop, do your grocery shopping on a budget. And we're going to do that based on a $300 a month cooking budget or food bill budget for a family of three. You might say to yourself, there's no way, or yeah, I can do that, that's simple. And really, it's not as simple as it sounds. $300 a month is not a lot of money to live to eat off of, not for three people. Okay, gotta kill one more ghostly wizard, and I do not see where my ghostly wizards are, so I gotta go find them. Kidoki. Gotta offer blessing. Hit the shrine here. When I died, the server lagged on me and locked me up to where I couldn't, I just didn't survive the onslaught of enemies. It was really stupid because it was a server lag issue. And unfortunately, it happens. It does. Even some of the best games. You just hope it doesn't happen to you. And if you're lucky, it doesn't. Okay, so we're going to up here. I need to launch over top of them. Working my way down towards my killing grounds where I gotta go find this enemy. I love the fact that you can fly in this game. This is an awesome feature. It's not really flying, it's hang gliding, guys. And it's just the most awesome thing. Really, it is. I'm gonna land right over here somewhere. Yeah, right here. It's really close to being good. Oh, that took me up really high. Oh, that brought me down really low. I did not want more of these. That's three of them. Run, 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 baby, run. Get the heck up out of there before you get your ass handed to you. Oh, pardon my language, folks. I'm a gamer. I battle in. That means I lost at least one of them. And here's one that I really need. So I'm going to call in my battle pet. Don't want my battle pet getting killed completely before I can heal him. grabbed a few more in the process. I'm gonna die again, guys. I guarantee you. Pet's about to die.
Selected.
Yeah, didn't last very long. Alright. This game, the downside to it is every time that you die, you get sent back to one of these shrines, or temple shrines, whatever you want to call them. And you gotta work your way all the way back to where you were at. And the trick to that is if you can fly there is so much more fun. Otherwise, yeah, you're wasting your time. We go up. This is a move that allows you to hang in the air a lot longer. It does slow you down a bit, but use it in combination with the right ones, and you can actually keep climbing while you're flying from off of a level launching pad. I'm trying to hit that lift again almost. Okay, now watch this. We'll heal our pet some. We'll heal. I do heal quickly, but we're going to actually help it along a little. Can hit the pet again while we're doing it. Pet's almost done. I'm almost halfway healed again. I can hit that ukulele or whatever the heck it is again here in a moment. Can't even use a healing potion. I'm out of healing potions. So let me look at my inventory. I do have some. I use one of those for now. And we'll replace that right there with that. Oh, come on, really? Unlock. That one in there. Looks like that's about it. Okay, alright, I'm gonna do some boring stuff, so give me a moment. Oh, let's hope this thing stayed on when I clicked that. Looks like it. Okay, let's hope, hope I do an okay job with this. We switched cameras yet again. Going back to a different camera, so hopefully I get a little bit longer. I don't have to worry about my 20 minutes in case I'm in the middle of a battle or something. I don't want to have to be trying to figure out, oh, I've got to restart my camera while I'm doing this. Yeah, I'm not much of a game vlogger, but hey, I don't mind it. I love having company while I play my games. Quite interesting, some of the things that we'll say and do in the games, and how we'll act, the psychology of it. It's really pretty neat. I keep forgetting how I do this, but we'll just do it like this. call out. And we will switch back. There we go. And we got my mount out now. And I'm actually almost where I need to be. And I'm quite actually right where I need to be, actually.
Very nice, very nice.
We're currently getting ready for Hurricane Mathew to come through. I am on the east coast of Florida, so we are going to see probably somewhere between 85 to 100 mile an hour winds where I'm at. Good possibility I will have to evacuate. If I do, I'm going to keep recording for as long as I can, as long as I have power to recharge my batteries. I'm going to be not doing a whole lot of recording today, so this is probably going to be a multi-day vlog. Possibly even longer, because I don't know how long it might be if we do lose our power. The vlog will get, I can't upload. I don't own a laptop, so and I don't have any portable computer system. So as you can see, I've pretty much cleared my backyard as best I can of all things that could be lifted off by the hurricane. Gotta cross my fingers that nothing else gets. So I got a lot of trees buffering the house, so I'm a little bit less worried about damage to the house. But I'll be keeping you guys. I'll be giving you guys a nice view of what it's like to be in a hurricane. It's a unique opportunity for me and a great opportunity for the rest of you to see what it actually is like to witness a hurricane. I am not evacuating unless absolutely necessary. My house can handle it. I'm going to be putting up wood shutters over. I'm going to be covering over these windows here. Those are the only primary windows. My front door, I don't have a way of covering it. I'll probably tape it. Yeah, we're going to do what I can to best secure the house. This house is 40 years old. It's withstood many a hurricane, so I'm going to do my best. But for the time being, I will be recording as much as possible. I have my cell phone. I have my other cell phone. And as long as I've got power and the ability to charge them, they will remain plugged in so that the batteries will last me as long as I can get them to last. Mind you, I probably will not be using my operating cell phone to do any recording, but I will use my 3GS for as long as the battery on it will last. So, hey guys, as you can see, I've moved my computer into my bedroom, and my bedroom's a little bit of a mess. I'm watching the forecast, the current forecast on Hurricane Mathew. It's going to be, for southern Florida, it's going to come closest to land near my area, which means that in the area I'm in right now, we are looking at approximately 100 to 115 to 130 mile an hour sustained winds. I have oversized sliders, so I had to tape them. There's no way to board them. This is what we call a Florida room out here. Let me get out here real quick. And what a Florida room is like a patio.
But it has the ability to be closed off. The screen has, we have the ability to close off the screen windows. So it's kind of like across, and make it a closed in room. It's kind of like, a Florida room. this is all aluminum. Hang on just a moment. I think I got something going on my headset. Sure do. Gotta turn that off. So basically, the winds are going to be coming from the north, which is this direction. So I've got a solid wall here. I'm not super worried about this getting blown in. These are vinyl. They're very strong. I put them up myself. I know the material. I purchased the material. I did my research on it. This material can withstand a very, very large impact without tearing, as long as it's not a sharp object. Blunt objects, it can handle quite a bit of pounding and not. Plus, I've got the screen on the other side, and each of these railings, they won't break, but they'll bend. I've moved in everything out of my backyard. Unfortunately, it's all right here, that nasty ashtray that I have because I have friends that still smoke. So I don't know, let's see here. You can see this or not. Let's zoom in. Alright, back there in that corner of the yard is where I tied up any loose yard debris that I couldn't get the trash man to take, which I thought was ridiculous because, I mean, come on, I can pick it up with one hand. Yeah, no reason for it. There is no reason for that. So we'll go ahead, we're gonna raise this up. Ouch. That closes off this door. We are now sealed in here. This is my laundry room, so it can stay the way it's at. Taped my front door. And my kid's playing. Hey, John, you need to go get some clothing on. Daddy, be right back in, okay? Okay. As you can see, the wind is starting to pick up. I've got big trees in my backyard, so let me give you guys a nice shot of this. That is Hurricane Mathew right there. That is all Hurricane Mathew. That is south. That's just the outer bands. We are just now seeing the outer bands. And then that's directly south, and then this is north. And as you can see, the wind will be whipping back this way. It's gonna start forming a circular pattern. Most of the damaging winds will be coming from north of me once these bands get past me. Bands aren't too bad. They're not devastating. Boarded up the house. Got boards over all my windows. Locked up everything. Got everything off the property that could possibly get picked up and lost.
Now I've seen a couple of cars go over, so I don't hold the protocols yet, but I have some calls into the local authorities to get those answers for you. We will bring those answers back to you. That is the very latest here. We are live in Vero Beach. Alyssa Hyman, WPTV News Channel 5.
Businesses will also be closed. If you need a shelter, the one Juno Beach needs to head to is Palm Beach Gardens Community High School. Also,
you continue to evacuate across all of South Florida. Right now in Delray Beach, those police officers blocking off the entrances to the barrier island. And that's where we find John Genovese with more on the bridge blockade.
We are standing off Atlantic Avenue in Delray Beach, and police have this side of the intercoastal blocked off. Take a look. They set up this barricade around 8 o'clock last night, and at this point, they are only letting local traffic through per county recommendations. They just don't want to take the risk. The closer the water that you get, obviously, the higher potential for flooding. We have seen a lot of folks try to walk towards the beach, drive towards the beach, that are getting turned around. We spoke with a couple of guys who were hoping to watch the waves as this storm moved in. They talked about how they've been preparing tonight.
We're just kind of playing it by ear. We're going to, hunker down in one of our apartments and ride it on out. Hopefully we end up all right.
It's a little nerve-wracking, I'm from Maryland, so I've been through a couple of hurricanes, but they're talking this one might be pretty serious, so never been this close to the shoreline before.
Now we've had some on and off sprinkles, a little truck that was actually passing through this barricade to go to the fire station not far from here. They say they plan to evacuate around 4 o'clock this afternoon, and they are urging everyone in this area to do the same. For now, in Delray Beach, John Genovese, WVTV, News Channel 5.
Folks, you might lose power very soon, and you need to remember when the power does shut down, we'll still be on air. How? Well, we'll keep you informed through our radio partners. Maybe you're just listening in. Take a snapshot of this right here on your screen. The radio stations, including 1230, WBZT, the talk station, among many others, that will simulcast our newscast so we can keep you up to date and
these are the wind gusts that they're talking about. Right now, they're only about 20, 25 miles an hour. And they're just blowing the leaves around a bit, making a lot of noise. But nothing majorly significant has happened just yet. We'll go take a look out front if it's still dry and not raining like it is in the backyard. It's dry. We'll take a step outside and take a look at what we'll give you guys a outdoor feel of what it's going to be like, what it's like right now. All right. These are the winds that are coming out of the north. You can see all of the leaves being blown to the right here. That's pointing south. The road I'm on is southeast facing, so when it goes south and east, it kind of faces at this little angle, but this is basically south and that's east, so I guess more like this, a little cockeyed in the other direction. But anyways, you're looking at east. That's where the storm's going to be. We're probably 5 miles or so from where that's going to hit. I'm waiting to see if that big Australian pine back there in the back overlooking that house right in front of me is going to withstand the winds. I'm really hoping my big old majestic trees here hold. They're my wind buffer. I love trees. Guys, if you're going to live in a state that's prone to hurricanes and its natural defense for hurricanes is a high foliage, you don't want empty yards. You're going to suffer more damage. The more trees, the more things you have to break up the wind, the better off you are, as long as they're sturdy. I mean, these are young palms. They won't go anywhere, most likely. I'm a little bit worried about that big palm right there on the edge of my property there. But if it falls, it will, wow, look at how much it's just moving those limbs around. We're not even in the storm yet. Shoot, these are right about considered tropical storm level winds. This is about tropical storm strength winds, about 20 to 30 miles an hour. What's expected to hit here is going to be closer to 100 and something, with gusts over 130 miles an hour. And when they say gusts, right now, these are gusts. They come and they go. We'll get a period of calm, and then the wind will pick up and go really, really hard, and then it'll calm down again. We're just already seeing a little bit of, this came out yesterday, damage from yesterday, actually, so that's okay. We'll just stick it down in there, and it should be all right. I'm gonna try to figure out, I'm gonna try to get you out here in some of it. I won't come out in the most dangerous parts. Very seriously doubt you can see me in this lighting.
I'm just standing on my back porch. I'm watching the weather. The rain's pounding pretty hard. I got a few down branches in the backyard. Looks like a few minor things just got loose. I don't know if you can see anything at all out there. I even have the light on. Let's sit here. See if we can do it this way. There we go. A little bit better. But there's a small branch that's been down. The breeze feels really good. These are the leaves dancing above us. This is how much wind is hitting us at the moment. The patio has not started to flood. This has actually been a lot more wind than rain. That being said, this is only the beginning. What it's doing south of here is just... yeah, I would not want to be there. I'm going to see if I can't get you a little bit of a peek out the front door before it gets too much worse. I think people that like to be out in this weather are kind of nuts. Well, that was me before I had kids, and in many ways still is me. I love to be out in this weather. We're going to take a peek out here, just a little peek. Let's get a little light. I'm going to stay really close to the house just to get an idea, because this little bush here, now remind you, my parents' RV is blocking a lot of this wind. But let me see. I don't know what you can see down there, but let me shut off the light. It might be too much light. Use what little light, less lighting might be a little bit better, because you might be able to see what I'm talking about. That's the moon. Or no, that's a street lamp. Sorry, I'm being a dum-dum. yeah, that's the hurricane, guys. That's it back there. All that flashing, and that's trees flipping back and forth. You hear the frogs? They like to come out during hurricanes. They really do. I remember the very first hurricane I was ever in. I was very, very, very young. In fact, I was only 4 years old the last time I was in a Category 4 hurricane. And that was Hurricane David. Now, I fortunately missed Andrew. I had left Florida before Andrew hit. But I'm here for Matthew, which is supposedly going to be twice as bad, at least. Hey everybody, this is the day after the hurricane, and we were very lucky. I'm going to be right back inside, okay guys? I'll be back to see you breakfast. I got lucky. As you can see, I have power, guys. I have power. I'm one of the luckier ones in my area. We didn't get hit as bad, but I mean, you can see there's a bit of yard debris, yeah, a little bit, stuff that got ripped off the trees, some of my palm branches got busted down from the palm trees, but they held up fairly well. The big palm tree held amazingly. It's bending, it's leaning, it may need to come down. Yeah, it looks like it's still up there though. We'll have to clean this mess up. But fortunate, could be a whole lot worse. Just a few little branches here and there. A little bit of
stuff. Even the rest of the neighborhood doesn't look too bad. And they've already been out and picked up their yard and got the crap off of their yard. Somebody had their beer party last night. Not too thrilled about people that do that, but hey. If they would pick up after themselves, it wouldn't bother me so bad. But as you can see, we didn't suffer any major damages. All the glass is still there, and in the same number of pieces that I left it in. The house is in the same number of pieces I left it in. My poor maple tree lost a few branches. Quite a few branches, actually. It's still in there hanging. And my big tree survived. Both of my big trees survived. That's my other big tree right there. But they both survived, and they, I'm gonna have a little bit of yard waste to pick up. But outside of that, it doesn't look too terribly bad. We'll trim it up and put a big old pile out for the trashmen to pick up, and you know, I'll be happy. I can't complain. Could have been way worse. Although it's still starting to rain, we are still getting some of the after effects. The wind right now is probably in the 20 to 30 mile an hour range. Still whipping around pretty good, but not bad, not too bad. And it's still coming in gusts, so we'll give it till a little bit later today, and that should die down quite a bit and go back to normal.
Daddy.
Yes, baby. I'm gonna move it just a tiny bit on you. I wanna get a picture of what you're doing.
50. Something 50. Hold on. Might be that piece in your hand.
Maybe.